Now, such applications are what are called N-tier applications, because if you look at the software stack that comprises an application such as this, you'll see several different layers. You have a presentation layer, and the presentation layer is the one that is responsible for painting the screen on your browser, perhaps dynamically generating the page based on the request you've made, and there may be application logic that corresponds to what the service is providing, and there is business logic that corresponds to the way airfares are decided, seats are allocated, all these kinds of things. And there is a database layer that accesses the database that contains information about all the things that the application and the business logic have to decide on in order to satisfy a particular request. And all these different layers have to worry about many of the issues that we are already familiar with in the context of writing parallel programs or distributed programs, and those include persistence for actions. For example, let's say I've made a choice, but I haven't completed the booking. I may go away and come back later on in order to complete that booking. So persistence is something that I might need. You need a notion of transaction because I've initiated a particular operation and I've not completed it. And so transactional properties may be needed in order to make sure that a reservation that started is finally complete and I've made the booking. Caching of data that you pulled in from a database server so that you can access the database more quickly. Clustering, which corresponds to taking a set of related services and clustering it together in order to improve the performance of the service. And similarly, clustering the data that you're accessing from a database server. All of these are issues. And of course, one of the things that we worry about a lot these days in e-commerce is security. In particular, when we are communicating financial information, credit card information, and personal information like social security IDs and so on, we worry a lot about services provided by the server and that my personal information is not compromised in any fashion. So these are all the sets of issues that N-tier applications have to worry about, and making sure that the services it provides are trustworthy from an end user's point of view. So how do we structure an N-tier application like this? The things that we want to reduce is reduce the amount of network communication because that results in latency, reduce security risks for the users, which means that the business logic should not be compromised, and increase the concurrency for handling an individual request. For instance, there's an individual request, but in processing this request, there's an opportunity to exploit parallelism. Oftentimes, these are called embarrassingly parallel applications because even though this request seems like a single request, there's an opportunity to exploit parallelism, and the kind of parallelism is embarrassingly parallel because the same query, I want to find out the availability of seats on a particular date, I don't care about which airline I go by, that's an opportunity for parallelism for the Expedia server to go in parallel to multiple airlines and find out the availability of seats on the dates that I've requested. Similarly, there is opportunity for exploiting concurrency across several simultaneous requests that are coming in, and also for clustering the computation that may have to be done on the server for computations that are common across simultaneously arriving requests. We want to reuse components aggressively. By components, we mean portions of the application logic that can be reused in constructing these applications as well as in the execution of the components in order to service the requests that are coming in simultaneously from several different clients.